Then we're going to jump into the integumentary system. So we had a question come in, and this was a lot of fun to do. Can you please discuss ICD-9 coding for skin wounds, ulcer, abscesses, infections, and cellulitis? I'm looking to clarify the difference between wound and other types of skin issues previously listed. Well, I'm going to give you a little heads up, guys. You know I kind of like pictures, right? So I did go pull some pictures.
Thank you, Alicia.
So I'm just telling you now, nothing too bad. My children came in throughout the day and kept saying, what are you looking at? But they're so used to me looking at this stuff.
Am I going to be able to post this to YouTube?
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah, one of my favorite doctors, educational doctors on YouTube, got someone turned in or whatever they do to him because he said this stuff was too gross or, you know. Okay, so again, they wanted some clarification. So and it is very confusing. Some of these terms, they kind of play into each other, but you want to make sure that you understand the differences. And I gave an example of some ICD-9 coding that would be involved in that. So wound. First off, you need to know whenever you're doing wounds, the primary thing you're going to think about is the location. Where's the wound at? So what is a dictionary definition of a wound? It would be any injury to living tissue caused by a cut, blow, or impact, typically one in which the skin is cut or broken. And again, they've got cut, gash, laceration, tear, slash. So this is a an incised, you know, a cut to the palm of the hand, you know, and this is a no jagged edges, a straight, you know, this would be considered a laceration. And he's probably going to get some stitches in there, an antibiotic. So to go look at those codes, and I didn't do them on ICD-10, I should have, but open wound of hand, your choices are going to be open wound of hand, open wound hand complicated, or open wound hand with tendon involvement. So there's going to be 882 and you've got 0.0, 0.1, or 0.2. Well, this obviously is going to be an 882.0 because there's no complication here. You know, there's not jagged edges. You don't have to debride anything. You know, they're probably just going to they're going to clean it and just do kind of like a blanket stitch that thing up. Again, complicated, the doctor will tell you that it's complicated. It's more involved than just stitching up. They may have to realign the edges if it's real jagged because some of that tissue may not have good blood supply, so they'll cut away some of the skin and debride some stuff. You know, then that would be complicated. Or if it was so deep, and it could be this small of a cut, but if it went in so deep, like a stabbing wound, then again a tendon could be involved, and then they have to go in and sew that back together. There might be surgery involved, or you might not be able to ever move your thumb again. So tendon and ligaments are important to know, and that'll be in your documentation. You don't have to guess at this stuff. Now here we go. Ulcers. So an ulcer, again, very important location and often the stage. But there are so many kinds of ulcers. And so I took three different ones here. It's an open sore on an external or internal surface of the body caused by a break in the skin or mucous membrane that fails to heal. So this is actually the stomach or the esophagus. And I don't know if you can see that. There's the ulcer. You can even see where it was bleeding a little bit. You know, and this would be like, well, I just decided it was an esophageal ulcer. But your esophagus really doesn't look quite like that. That's more into getting into the stomach. Anyway, so that would be 530.21, ulcer of the esophagus with bleeding. And they want to know, is it bleeding or not bleeding, especially internally, because and the way they know that is either they have, they call it coffee ground emesis, so it looks like you're throwing up coffee grounds, and that's blood, or it passes and your stool is very, very dark. So they'll ask about that. Now, this is actually an ulcer. You know how, you know, when I had braces and I got hit in the mouth, oh, my mouth just, you know, you'd get these little ulcers and stuff, or little cold sore type ulcers, you know, and some people just have enough of this herpes complex thing. That's not the bad herpes that you're thinking of, but that's just in your system. And some people are kind of predestined to get these more often than others. But again, you get any type of a little cut or nick inside there, and it'll kind of ulcerate before it heals. But the inside of your mouth heals very, very quickly. So the next one would be like a pressure ulcer. And these are the ones where location as well as stage is very, very important. And an example of those would be ulcer of other part of the foot. That's what this would be, 707.15 for this ulcer. And then they're going to or you could have one of the back, which I didn't get a picture of the ones for the back because those are pretty, you know, gross. But that would be 707.03, pressure ulcer of lower back. But note that when you have an ulcer of like the foot or the back, these pressure ulcers or decubitus ulcers, they're going to want to know the stage, and you'll always see this indication, use additional code to identify pressure ulcer stage, and then it's 707.20 through 707.25. So it's very important with this type of an ulcer that the stage is in there, and the physician will put the stage. They're trained to do that, so that information will be included. Next, we have abscesses. And an abscess is classified as a swollen area within the body tissue containing an accumulation of pus. That's really all it is. It's an accumulation of white blood cells. So you've got a little problem, you know, let's say he's got a little problem here on his jaw, and, you know, it could have started out like a ingrown hair. It could have been anything. And it got a little infection in there, kind of closed over, but the white blood cells started accumulating to try to kill this infection. And so it swells up under the skin and gets very, very painful. And so this would be a 682.0 other cellulitis and abscess of the face, and then it says cheek, external, or chin. So this is the code that I would have used for that. Then it tells you to use an additional code to identify the organism. So let's say that they drain this. So they'll go in, they'll drain it, and they'll irrigate it real good and try to get the infection out. And then they'll swab it and send a culture off, and they want to know what is it. And so if it's like a staph infection, the staphylococcus, it would be 041.1. Okay. Now, when you do these, sometimes you won't know what the organism is right away because they had to go do a culture. And again, this would be like one from the hand. It could have been a bug bite. It could have been a little, you know, nick or something. But you get some staph in there or some other type of infection like Mrsa or something, then that is the white blood cells are going to congregate and go to attack that, and it's going to be under the skin. Again, it's very, very painful, and you do have to have an antibiotic. It's really, really bad. They'll put you on a IV antibiotic, you know, because this type of stuff can go septic if it's not taken care of. This redness, they don't want that redness to start traveling up your arm. Now, the 682, that is going to be abscesses that are acute, you know, and again, you're going to have to know another digit here, lymphangitis, except for finger or toe, cellulitis and stuff. And cellulitis was one of the terms that was asked about, and I believe that one is, oh, no, infection is next. So I told you about the staphylococcus, but there's one that you hear about a lot that's kind of scary, and that's, we call it MRSA, and that's M-R-S-A, but they call it MRSA. That's 041.12, and that is an infection, it says a condition classified elsewhere. It's a methicillin-resistant staphylococcus aureus, and it's resistant to medication. And so MRSA is just out there. It's everywhere. But most of us have enough antibiotics. You know, we don't really get not everybody gets MRSA. However, if they just can't get it to heal, say you had this hand condition up here and you know, it was healing, it was looking pretty good, and then it gets really bad again, and they go in and they swab it, and now they say, oh, that's MRSA. That's why it's not getting better. And there's treatments for that, but it's a big bad thing. You know, can you recover? Yeah, but you know, that's when you start going to wound care clinics and stuff like that, and they want to stay on top of it. But what type of infections are there? Well, you know, the way they know what type of infection is by the shape. And so they will go in and they'll do a culture, they'll grow something, and these are the different shapes that will tell them what type of infection bacteria is involved or virus. So they mentioned cellulitis, and a lot of people get cellulitis confused. But cellulitis is actually it's a bacterial skin infection, so it's on the skin. Okay, that's how you know it's different, and you'll see it. It'll be red and swollen. It'll be painful, and when you touch it, it's hot to the skin, you know, and real tender. So this is a child that has cellulitis. A hand, you can see they often draw a line because it's very important. They want to know if it's spreading, that means it's getting worse, versus they want to see that pink going away. And so, you know, 24 hours later after you've been on antibiotics, here's one on the inside of the leg, and see they were really paying attention to where that was at, that it would, you know, for it to spread. One of my children, he had banged the back of his heel, you know, you get it caught in a door, and he just really scuffed the back of his foot up. I didn't think anything of it, you know, we ran around barefoot, and he, my mother-in-law had noticed, you know, a few days later, she said, man, that's really red and swollen. I kept thinking, no, I think it's okay. And then the next day she said, no, you better take him in. The red was going up the back of his leg. And that's where, you know, you can have blood poisoning. And sure enough, we got him to the doctor and he said, yeah, this was starting to look bad. There was no pus involved or any, you know, so it didn't really look like it was infected, but it was cellulitis. And you don't want those lines, they were the old misses, you don't want it going towards your heart, you know, so the limbs will come in and up the legs. So those for cellulitis would be 682, and notice that's same as the abscess, right? Other cellulitis and abscess, so that's included, leg except foot, so that's what we would classify this one, this picture. The next one, other cellulitis and abscess, hand except fingers and thumb, and that's what you got there. And again, they want you to identify if there's an organism, and they give you a suggestion of 041.1 staphylococcus, but it could be MRSA. Again, so you're often going to have two codes, and you may not know what that is yet. So that's the difference between cellulitis, infection that causes these type of things. An abscess is an infection that's under the skin and growing. Ulcers, that type of wound, or another type of wound, which is just a breaking, a lesion, or a cutting of the skin. That a wound can be several types of injuries, but it's the skin is broken. Think of it that way. So that was a fun one.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.